Hello everyone, myself is Namita Ramakant Garude, Assistant Professor in Microbiology. Today's topic of discussion is qualitative detection of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are most abundant biomolecule on Earth. Certain carbohydrates are dietary staple in most part of the world. The oxidation of carbohydrates is the central energy yielding pathway in most of non-photosynthetic cells. The empirical formula for carbohydrates is CXH2OX. Carbohydrates plays two main roles. One is structural carbohydrates and second one is functional carbohydrates. Structural carbohydrates are required for formation of cell wall structure and functional carbohydrates required for providing energy in the form of ATP after breakdown of compound and also for storage purpose. Carbohydrates are polyhydroxyaldehyde or ketone, substance that yield on hydrolysis, are the carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are sugar molecule or saccharide molecules. They are of three types. First one is monosaccharide, second one is oligosaccharide, and third one is polysaccharide. Monosaccharide is made up of single unit of sugar. An example of monosaccharide is glucose and galactose. Oligosaccharide is made up of 2 to 10 glucose unit. An example is lactose and fructooligosaccharide. Polysaccharides are made up of more than 10 units of sugars. An example of polysaccharides are hemicellulose, lignocellulose, cellulose, starch, etc. Carbohydrates can be detected by different tests, for example, Mollis test, barcode test, Benedict's test, DNSA test, and Fehling's test. Let's start with the Mollis test. Mollis test is having two steps. One is dehydration and second one is condensation reaction. On the hydrolysis, acid hydrolysis, it releases water molecule and gives furfural as a main product. This furfural will react with the alkaline actor and gives you violet color. Procedure for the Mollis test. In a test tube, add 2 ml of the test carbohydrate solution and 2 drops of alkaline actor solution. Carefully incline the tube and pour drop-wise concentrated H2SO4 using dropper along the side of tube and observe violet color at the junction of the two liquid solution. Next one is Benedict's test. So Benedict's test is component for the Benedict's reagents are sodium sulfate, sodium carbonate, and pentahydride copper. So in this reaction, cupric ions reduce to cuprous ion, which is present in Benedict solution, and on the alkaline condition, heated alkaline condition, carbohydrate reduced to anhydride component, and these anhydride component will react with these reduced cuprous ion and gives you cuprous oxide, and this cuprous oxide gives you red precipitation. It indicates the presence of carbohydrates in the solution. The procedure for the Benedict's test is: take 5 ml of Benedict's reagent in the test tube and add 0.5 ml of test sample. Boil the tube for 5 to 10 minutes and pull down the tube for the 5 to 10 minutes, and after pulling the tube, observe for the coloration. Yellow or red, brick red color will indicate the presence of carbohydrates. Next one is barcode test. It is used to detect the presence of monosaccharide. So by using barcode test, you can distinguish between the monosaccharide and disaccharide molecule present in the test sample. Barcode's reagent, a mixture of ethanoic acid and copper acetate, it is combined with the test solution and boiled. A red copper oxide precipitate is formed, will indicate the presence of reducing sugar. The reaction will be negative in the presence of disaccharide sugar because they are weaker reducing agents. This test is specific for monosaccharides due to the weakly acidic nature of Barcourt's reagent, it is reduced only by monosaccharide. So procedure for the Barcourt's reagent: 2 ml of test solution and about 2 to 3 ml of Barcourt reagent. Mix it well and boil it for 1 minute. After boiling, observe for the coloration. Thank you.